Honorable Chairperson, Chief Guest, Jury Members, Other Guests, Principal from different schools, teachers, and my beloved friends. A warm afternoon to all ladies and gentlemen presented here. Today I am here to make a speech on the topic Contribution of Private Educational Institution in Nepal. We all know private educational institutions are those organizations or institutions which are run by a person or group of persons and owned by it. It does not belong to public. Private educational institutions are independent, non-governmental educational institutions aiming to provide good quality of education to all general public. Honorable Chairperson, contribution is not a big thing, it is just a combination of simple things. Sometimes we forget little things from our life, that little things can make our life and future bright. For an instant, we can see a GSUN. GSUN is the umbrella organization of a PAPSUN. We are here and express our feeling in front of this mass fluently. Have you ever thought how is this been possible? It has just been possible because of our schools. And our school is our private educational institutions. We know that education is a tool that makes an individual skill in doing their things with more perfection. If each and every job in this world are based on degree, on by education. If there is no education means no job, and no job means no survival. This is modern trend and is universal truth too. In Nepal, there are large number of private educational institutions and they are active in providing high standard formal, informal, technical as well as vocational education. Every year more than 90% of students pass SSC examination from private schools, but two-thirds of them who take board exam from public schools cannot take part through it. The success rate of private schools have never come down to 90%, but public schools have never able to cross 40% marks. Every year we see different news regarding miserable nil result of many public school SSC examination. The condition of public schools is getting worse day by day. The government of our Nepal is also not able to manage it properly. The quality of education provided by government school is not good quality. The teacher as well as managerial bodies are irresponsible towards their duties. Neither academic nor infrastructure is up to par. But if the situation is persist, then the students will be deprived from education and the country will go away from social, political as well as economic prosperity. Also, if you look at the scenario level of plus two and higher level technical education, then the number of government school is very low, which can be easily counted by our fingers. In that sector, the contribution of a private educational institution is very high. Also, if we want to spend our life in foreign countries, then we have to do different test preparations. All these test preparations are run by private educational institutions. So private educational institution is facing in every sector of our life, from a small baby to a grown-up man. In Nepal, private educational institutions not only provide good quality of education, but also maintain topmost discipline with equipped infrastructure. Let me remember you all. We all know what factory or company is. It is something that produces goods or product. Is it output? Isn't it? The same principle is worked in private educational institutions and public ones. Private educational institutions produce different qualities product with different multidimensional quality product which can be easily compete and sold at national as well as multinational market. It is like our multinational company with multidimensional quality. But public school is like our low-graded national company. Their product is fit in a certain place only. There is no any global reach. For in short, we can say that private educational institution is like our YY noodles and public educational institutions is like our bonus noodles. It also private educational institution also provide different opportunity to show our talent in front of people. For an instant, look at me, I'm here able and express my feeling in front of this mass fluently. Have you ever thought how is this been possible? It has just been possible because of our school. And let me remember. educational institutions. And to develop our country, first of all, we have to develop educational sector. And private educational institution not only develop educational sector, but also help in all-round development of our country. Being a developing country, Nepal needs different skilled manpower like doctors, engineers, pilots, agriculturists, etc. to take the country in the mainstream of development. To make this dream come true, private educational institutions play a vital role by producing different skilled manpower and saving millions of rupees from east and abroad. Sometimes we think, why private educational institutions is good and better than public educational institution? It is all because of the quality of education and also facilities provided by private educational institution. Education is very important in our life as it makes an individual empowering. Self-help is very easier for every educated people. Without education, we can't do anything. But in Nepal, private educational institutions are funded by a people, so their quality of education and facilities are improving day by day. But the government schools are funded by our government. So if any government is changed in Nepal, then the qualities as well as facility provided by government is also changed. By saying